Hello people, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, let's see some of the similarity measures which are used in clustering, especially in unsupervised learning, where we just categorize different objects into different clusters. So we start with what is basically similarity measure. So it's basically is a metric which determines how two objects are alike, means how they both are same. So consider I have these two objects. So these are two onions. Now everything in this world, the world we live in, is a three dimension. So everything has got a mass, length, breadth and height. And so essentially we can call it as LBH dimensions. And in some cases we can consider as the texture or color. So now these are two onions, but the color of this is different. Now the shape is somewhat different and the size is also different, but the density is also different. So we can say that these are two different objects, but it belongs to one class. Means they belong to one class of onion, but we clustered them separately. That's why it's being sold separately. Now say for instance we have these two. So these are called as paprika or capsicum. So basically if we find out the features or different characteristics, say we have same color of stem, that is green, just don't go for the length of this. Then we have the same dimensions, it looks exactly like the same at the bottom. Then we have the same dimension, I can feel the density of this, and it's hollow from inside. But if we just separate it with the help of color, then we can't just put into different clusters. And so we can just club them together and we can sell them, or we can put them into one particular cluster. So essentially what I've did is I've just got the features or the feature matching between different objects. So based upon various dimension, we just categorize two different objects, how similar are they. So the similarity measure is a value which ranges from 0 to 1. So it is in this range. So if two objects have lower similarity score, or the distance is very small, that means they are not similar. Or if they have larger value of similarity, then they are similar. Means how closely two objects are there, or what is the characteristic that distinguishes between one object and the other object. Now there are certain ways where we estimate, or certain mathematical measures where we estimate the similarity measures in clustering. So I'll give an overview of those. So very first is we have the Euclidean distance. So say for example our data sets or objects are very dense, means in large number, or they are continuous. Like you have value ranges 0, 1, 2, 3 up till some number or some decimal point. So we mainly use Euclidean distance when we have dense or continuous attributes. So we mainly use Pythagoras theorem or Pythagoras formula in order to calculate the distance between two objects. So Euclidean distance between any two points, say we have x and y, is the length of the path connecting these objects. Say for instance I have this point, say this is x and this is y. Now this is the length that connects these two. Say this has coordinates x1 and y1, and this has x2 y2. Just consider this as b and this as a. So what this horizontal distance is x2 minus x1, and this will be y2 minus y1. So this distance is the Euclidean distance. So how you estimate mathematically? So distance between two points is given as square root of summation I runs from 1 to k xi minus yi the whole square. So this is how you calculate Euclidean distance with the help of Pythagoras theorem. Now secondly, we have a distance called as Manhattan distance. So this name is a place or a city in US called as Manhattan. So from there we got actually this name Manhattan distance. So say for example we have two locations, say two points. This is one location. These are four different locations, say A, B, C, D. So if we want to find the distance from this point to this point, or this point to this point, or intercity distances connecting between these two points internally, so we mainly use Manhattan distance in this. So Manhattan distance between any two points is the sum of the absolute difference of their Cartesian coordinates. What this means is basically in graph or in geometry you have different planes. So you calculate the longitude, latitude, so you have different coordinates. So there you mainly use Manhattan distance in order to calculate the separation of two different points or two different objects. So mathematically it is given as, so distance between any two points A or B or say X or Y is given as x1 minus x2, the absolute difference of their coordinates, and you sum it up. So this is how you give the Manhattan distance between any two points or any two locations. Now third type is when we have sparse data, means we have very few data, or in fact we can say sparse vectors or attributes. There we mainly use cosine similarity. So cosine similarity essentially finds a normalization of the dot product of two attributes. So it basically finds the angle of separation. We can call it as theta here. And so cosine similarity or cosine distance is mainly used, or it judges the orientation of two input vectors rather than their magnitude. Say you have two input vectors like this A and B over two planes. You have Y and X. So how you estimate if there are two input vectors A and B and there is a value theta? So how you estimate this theta value is basically by taking their cosine value. So if the two input vectors are in same direction, what you take is cosine of 0 degree, that is 1. If they are perpendicular to each other, that is like this. So you have the cosine degree of 90, that is 0. Else they are diametrically opposite, something like you have a circle like this. So if they are here, one is towards this direction, other is towards this direction, so it's separated with 180 degree, so it is -1. And so you have different values, so it ranges in the value between 0 to 1. So mathematically how you estimate, you have the similarity between A and B with cosine distance, or in fact similarity, in place of similarity you can also write as cosine. So it is taken as the dot product of two input vectors, and you calculate their vector norm, that is the cross product. So this is how you mathematically estimate the cosine similarity. So these are some overview of the distances, similarity measures which are there in clustering. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to get educated watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.